towards science, I maybe started to not lose faith, but just I started to have more doubt. I've always had a hard time connecting with people. It's not something I'm very good at. A lot of people find me difficult because I can be blunt, because I can be difficult, stubborn, and I know that about myself. And on one hand, yeah, I need to be able to compromise, maybe, and I need to, you know, be maybe more delicate in some situations. But on the other hand, I am who I am, and if I have to try to be fake to get you to like me, then that's not a real relationship. That's not a friendship. So it's like the struggle, right? So, anyways, what I was saying. Over the last 4 or 5 years, I've never lost my faith in God. I've always believed there is a God. But I started to struggle with having fun and getting to care about having, you know, muscles and getting to listen to music that is more secular and getting to like connect with people. I felt like it was one or the other. It was, you had to be a really good Christian and listen to Christian music and go to church and not drink and not cuss and not wear skimpy outfits, and you have to do those things, or you're of this world. And I felt the last 4 or 5 years, it's been this constant battle between, am I a good Christian girl, or do I feel guilty because I'm not being a good Christian girl, and I want to connect with people, and maybe that means going out and like having a drink with them or something. And it's been this battle, like this internal battle that I've had. And I think if there's something to be gained about the last 4 months is also that I'm learning that I can be a Christian and I can have genuine relationships with people. And that has nothing to do with the music I listen to or the clothes I wear or whatever else it is. So there's that. Okay. So that's kind of like this academic background for me, what I've been doing college-wise. I've worked other jobs besides server jobs. I've worked career jobs. I've set my mind to growing my resume, and I've done that, and I've been successful at that. I think, you know, I decided I was going to pharmacy school. I got in. I had that. I did that, and I left when I thought it was the right thing to do. And I hope that I still keep thinking that. Right now, I still do believe that leaving where I was at is and was the right decision. Going forward, I'm still figuring out what I'm doing. I knew when I quit that I was making the decision to spend the next like 9 months preparing for the world show and getting a job that, you know, gave me an income and I could start paying off bills and getting out from under some of these loans, and not so much focusing on career. Maybe more about self-love and self-growth and development and all of those things, I think, has been something I've needed to do for the last 4 months and into the next 5 months or so. You know, I'm exploring different areas. I struggle with feeling like I haven't lived up to my fullest potential, or I've disappointed people, or I've disappointed myself, or I've let people and myself down. And I look at my age and I look at, I have no real plan of what I'm doing in the future. And that's so scary to me. And there's been so many changes the last couple months. And that has been difficult for me. But I am trying to stay positive and look at everything as an opportunity to learn and grow. I know that there are some people that will watch this video or learn more about my story, and they will tell me that, you know, I'm lucky or I'm spoiled or entitled or whatever it is that people have said about me my whole life, that my reality is different than your reality. And that's true. I am blessed that I do have a place that I can kind of regroup and get myself together and get some loans paid off, hopefully, and that I can do this horse thing and, you know, have this time with my mom to pursue something that we have always wanted to do together and go to the world show together and give it everything that I have. I am so lucky to have that. I am blessed, and I know that. Just because my reality is different than your reality, I don't think it means that I am better or worse off than you. I think that we are all capable of learning from each other, and I think that wherever we are, we should support each other. And if you really want something, you work for it and you don't let it go and you hold on to it and you fight. I want the world show. I want to ride and show horses with my mom this year on Bentley. It is important to me because it is long overdue, and I have struggled with horses. If you want to know about running around in an arena with the horse's head high up and being that girl that comes out in tears because you're so embarrassed and scared and everything in between, I am your girl. This is the first year that I have had a horse that is like, actually since I was a little kid, like 6 years old, my first horse, paint horse. This is the first year that I have a horse that does all these events and is actually really pretty good minded. I love Frenchie and she will always be a part of me, but she had that thoroughbred in her, so she could be a little unpredictable at times. So if you want to know about crazy horses, I can tell you about crazy horses too. If you want to know about taking risks from college and jobs, I can tell you about it. Standing up to people or giving in to people, I've had to grow and learn a lot. I used to be this super shy girl, like sitting here talking to whoever will watch this video, I would have never dreamed of being able to do. When I first started my first job when I was like 14, I couldn't even look people in the eye. I was so shy and so scared of being judged. And I still carry around some of those feelings of being judged by others. But I have gotten so much more confidence in just owning who I am and where I am in life and being okay with it, because at the end of the day, you should be happy. You have one life to live, as cliche as that sounds. Why are you stuck in a job? Why are you not trying to do what you love? Why are you conforming to what the world says you should be doing at a certain age? I try to remind myself of that every day. The days that are harder than others. This week has been a little bit more challenging for me, especially as I've been extra laid up and I've had other personal stuff that's happened, but I believe it will all work out. And the right things and the right people and the right jobs and horses and everything else, I think it'll all work out. I am currently, you know, like I said, growing and reflecting and thinking about the future and what jobs I want to have it's crazy that now I think about it, and it's like owning my own business, it actually sounds exciting and fun. And 5 years ago, 3 years ago, that was the furthest thing from something I wanted to do. And now it's like I've owned up to my family name in a sense, and like what they do, what they love, and what inspires them. I don't know. But I hope that sharing my story, parts of it, I know this has been a really long rant and ramble, and it has been emotional and everything else for me. I hope that something that I say today and that I've said in this video will resonate with one of you, and maybe it'll help one of you make that brave choice to do what lights your soul on fire and to not settle and to not believe that you aren't valued, because you are, and I am, and you need to own it and not apologize. I know that sounds super cheesy, but it's true. Things will always change. It's true. But you gotta live your best life. That's what I'm trying to do. With every decision that I make, I'm trying to live my best life.